Hi. In this example, we're asked to simplify the radical expression 3 times the fourth root of 80x plus 8 times the fourth root of 5x. And you notice, as it's written here, though these are both fourth roots, we do have the fourth root of 80x and the fourth root of 5x. Those are not the same. They don't match exactly, which means we can't add these together yet. With radicals, you need to have the radicals match exactly, as if they were like terms, before you can actually combine them. This doesn't mean that there's nothing we can do and that this is as simplified as this problem gets. What we want to do is break each radical up into simple radical form, meaning simplify it as much as possible, and in the process see if we can get them to actually be the same. To start this process, let's look at our first one here. Just by itself, the fourth root of 80x. We want to break this up and see if we can simplify any parts of it out of the radical. So let's start with the 80. What I want to do is rewrite 80 in its prime factors. See what small numbers multiply together to actually make up 80. There are a lot of ways to do this, and here I'm going to use a tree diagram. So I'm going to take 80 and just come up with two numbers that multiply to 80. Any two numbers you think of. The first two I thought of, 8 and 10. Since neither of these are prime numbers, we're going to break them up and see what multiplies together to make them. 8 is going to be 2 times 4. 10 is going to be 2 times 5. Of these, only the 4 is not a prime number, meaning 2, 2, and 5, they're all prime. But the 4 can break up to be 2 times 2. So from what we see here, we can tell that 80 is going to be equal to 2 times 2 times 2 times 2. These are the four twos that we found in our diagram here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Those twos multiplied together times the 5 that was there in the diagram. So if we take our original radical here, we can rewrite it as the fourth root of 2 to the 4 times 5, that's the 80, times x, the x that was in the original right there. Since we know that the fourth root of 2 to the 4 is 2, that works out perfectly, we can go ahead and take that root. So we end up with 2 times the fourth root of 5x. That's it in simple radical form. So you notice, simplifying this, we end up with a radical, the fourth root of 5x, that now matches the other radical from my problem. That's perfect. It means we can go ahead and add these two together. So since I've run out of room here, let me move this up to have a little bit more space. And I'll rewrite my original problem. The original problem was 3 times the fourth root of 80x plus 8 times the fourth root of 5x. Now, in simplifying this radical, we found that the fourth root of 80x is actually the same as 2 times the fourth root of 5x, which means I can substitute that in. 3 times 2 times the fourth root of 5x, and that'll be added to my other 8 times the fourth root of 5x. Just to make life a little easier here, we're going to go ahead and multiply this 3 times 2. Rewriting my first one to be 6 times the fourth root of 5x plus 8 times the fourth root of 5x. Now that these guys match, you notice I have exactly the same radical, the fourth root of 5x, the fourth root of 5x. They are both fourth roots, and they also have exactly the same inside. These match exactly. They are like terms, which means I can go ahead and actually add them up. and we add them the same way we would add like terms if they were just variables here, we end up adding the coefficients, the numbers out front. So we end up with 14 times the 4th root of 5x. That's our simplified answer, down to just one radical from the original two we had.